Hello, hello. I'm Kelly.
And I'm Terry, and we're certified EFT therapists and supervisors.
Yes, and we are here at the Lodge Franklin. This is where we're going to host our very first, and we're going to have more, play and practice.
Yes.
Trainings. And so it's experiential training. Play as in role play.
Mm-hmm.
And practice as in practice.
We're gonna do it.
We're gonna actually do it. EFT is an experiential model. You cannot actually really get it unless you learn it experientially. And so we'll give you just a little snippet of what you can expect. A lot of people get really confused, or there's like not a ton of practical ways or to think about. And this is what we're going to try to give you as practical ways to think about: how do you hold both partners in a coupleship as you're tracking the cycle, working through a tango? How in the world do you do that?
Anybody else get nervous about that? I know, especially when I was first starting out, and then even still sometimes wondering, okay, how do I hold both of them,
yeah,
you know, throughout the process, especially in stage one. But if there's attachment injuries, if there's stuff that's happening, if there's new information, right?
Yes.
Any of this come up that we start to wonder, am I going to lose the other person?
Am I going to lose you?
When I'm working with one.
Yeah.
And so that's what we're going to talk about.
I like what you're saying throughout, because that's true. We think, oh, we're stage two, we're golden. No, you got to hold both partners, because the relationship is your client.
Right.
This is like not just a concept. This is a practical, like, intervention. Actual, we're looking at these two people on the couch as if it's one.
It's one, right? And so what we were talking about with each other is when you're tuning in and you're going deeper and you're focused on one of the partners in the relationship, you don't ever lose your attunement and focus with the other partner. And so what we've looked at is, how do you do that?
Like practically.
Practically, literally.
Literally.
Right? What is our anchor there?
Yes.
How do we hold on to that? And this is what we really decided. And we both really do a very similar thing in this way. And so what we did here, you talk about
nonverbal. Okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, we actually just kind of talked to each other about what we've naturally done. And then we're like, oh my gosh, there's like three things. It's in order too.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are working with one partner, and I have to add, we're going to have application for EFIT, individual, EFFT, family, and EFT couples. We're talking about couples, but this has applications for every single part of EFT or way to do EFT. What's the word I'm looking for?
Every modality, every way that it shows up.
Yeah, thank you. And so when you're working with one, and you know, whether you feel it or not that you're losing the other one, you're going to want to use nonverbals to attune to the other one when you're talking to one. So that could look like, okay, you know, help me understand. Yes, of course you, da da da. And then you just glance over and smile, or, you know, maybe like just some kind of like acknowledgement of the other partner. And that's kind of, then they know they're not, that you've still got them, right?
Yeah.
So nonverbals is your first go-to.
Okay, so if they need a little bit more regulation, a little bit more support, then, and you've had your nonverbals, so you have that still, you still have eye contact, you still maybe can look at them, even turn your head, but also then the next sort of level, the next layer is proximity. So sitting in close, using your physical presence to help regulate your clients, right? So even if I'm working with this person, I'm still sitting in close.
Right.
Right?
Yep. And I think that also includes touch.
Mm-hmm.
It's perfectly fine.
I'm just grabbing you right now.
I mean, of course you want to have rapport and alliance, right?
Yeah.
You kind of have to earn this. But if you see that you're working with one and the other is like getting a little fidgety, you might just like put your hand on their knee, right? Or maybe their foot. Something where you're like, I still got you. It matters to me. I see you. And I'm going to get to you.
That's right.
Right? It's, you're going to have your time and space to kind of give your perspective of what's happening inside for you.
That's right. And we were talking about it kind of like what we do with our kids.
Yes.
Right? If we're in conversation and one of our kids wanted to come and talk to us, they can put their hand on our leg and we hold their hand, and it's really communicating. I got it.
Yeah.
I'm receiving the signal that you're sending to me. I'm sending a signal back to you that's clear.
That I'm going to get to you. I'm going to finish my conversation, and then I'm going to, you know, answer your question or hear you. But we have to train our kids to do that. They don't just know to do that.
No.
You know, you have to say, okay, when mommy is talking to another adult, you don't just interrupt, right? You give me a signal. And so we can be really explicit with our clients. We can say, you know, this is probably going to be hard. I'm going to try to kind of help navigate this conversation. If you ever feel like, eesh, this is hard for me, just wave your hand. Let me know. Say something, and I will be with you, right? And then we can make a decision as clinicians. Like, are we gonna change courses? Are we gonna just kind of like attune and soothe and then go back? Like, what are we going to do at that moment?
We'll talk more about that.
Yeah.
When you come to play and practice about what to do when you're at that point.
That's right.
And then at the next level, so you've had your nonverbals, you've got proximity, you may actually need to go to the third level, which is then to have something verbal happen. So you may need to ask them, are you with me?
Yes.
Have I lost you?
Are we still having?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Or, do we need to slow down for a minute? Do you need to take a breath?
Yeah. Like, I see you. Tuning in. I can tell that something's triggering. Are we good?
That's right. Exactly.
My son is, talk about proximity.
We're going to do play and practice right now.
Hi, buddy. I need to go something. Oh, honey, I'm so sorry.
A dolphin died in the movie, guys. Yeah. Okay. So, hey, I'll be right with you in a second, okay? Yeah. This is what we're talking about.
Actually what we're talking about right now.
This is actually what we're talking about. So we really want you to join us. We want to give you nuggets like this, and then, you know, you'll learn it, and then you're actually going to try to do it.
That's right. So we will be here August 17th here at the Lodge in Franklin from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We'll have lunch, and we hope to see you here.
Yay!
Register. Right at the link below. Can't wait to see you. Bye. Yeah.